The guy in charge had taken now this empty vase, which was full of water but with no flowers, and this girl said, don't, Beth. And he said, I got enough, and he ran into this toilet and he opened the door, and there was Sid with his foot in the toilet and all this water rushing out. Sid had actually tried to wash his foot, you know, by pulling the chain. And this guy threw this vase of water at him, and Sid hurled back and bashed his elbow through the window of the toilet. And I'll never forget, because I was just coming up the stairs, you see, and Sid said, Malcolm, what kind of bloody record company is this? Said, I've been kind of woken up. Look what they've done. They bashed my bloody arm in. So I don't think we should be around this record company anymore. And that was it. And of course, 5 days later, we weren't. But we were 150 grand richer.
Well, that was another scam with all the clothes, because, like, we had to buy the clothes from his shop, and we'd be on the stage and all the kids would see it, and they'd buy all the clothes, and so we was buying them as well, where, you know, we should have gone for nothing, you know what I mean?
I blew a light that's full, I traveled it, and every highway and more, much more than this, I get my way.
Sometimes we used to turn him off, actually.
It used to be Steve Ball.
We'd elastoclast all the dials on the amp.
He says, what do you do that for, Malcolm?
Don't worry, Sid. You don't need to worry about playing bass. You just keep talking to the girls.
He didn't care. How was he thinking about him?
And I think the only rule I ever had was the fact that if it didn't annoy anyone, it wasn't worth doing. If it didn't create problems, too, it was also not worth doing. If it didn't have any politics, it was suspect. And from that, it then had to have a lot of style and be sexy to sell.
It's the catastrophe. It is the real catastrophe behind a lot of these songs, in a lot of these stories in operas, that marries so well with punk rock, hip hop, rhythm and blues, because it epitomizes all the chaos and disaster that surrounded rock and roll when I first heard it. So, you know, I could be diabolic here and say, you know, it's the closest thing to anarchy in the UK.
5 minutes! 5 minutes! Final call! Final call!
Dear Peter, I am one of your biggest fans.
Well, Fans was a song really just about a fan in love with a pop star. There's never been a song about a fan so much, and certainly not from the caustic and obvious presentation of the pop star taking a back stage position. And I decided I was going to use George and do this wonderful King of Thieves job where I was going to steal all these famous pop stars' lines when they say, oh, my next song is, and this is Harry over here on the bass, and we just got back from Australia, and this is Charlie on piano, and there would be all this screaming going on, right? And in between all that, I'd have this song of this girl that would just be maybe writing a love letter to a pop star.
I have every record that you've ever made. Get on stage so I can kiss him. All of your posters, I got them out of the magazine. They cover my entire room.
Good luck, sir.
But working on this opera album, I decided George and Sting and Simon Le Bon really were too hacky. And I thought some big burly fella singing a song about none shall sleep tonight until I break my lips upon some luscious princess and then she will be mine. And those lyrics conveyed a kind of the right sentiment for me, and so luckily I made the marriage between this girl writing a fan letter to a guy singing in the back room before he was going on stage to sing this particular opera called Turandot, of which that song Ness and Dorman, None Shall Sleep, figures on it.
Fan at once. I had so many idols that I wanted to, you know, get close to and talk to, and I did write a fan letter once before.
It took me 3 hours to write it. Just to say that I really and truly love you.
They've never been projects that that you could ever talk about as being things to do with a group's personal career. Career is probably the last word.
Yeah,
it's the last word that ever enters one's mind. I'm also interested. I mean, if Annabella got run over by a bus, we'd have another girl to fit her place the following morning. In fact, it may even ignite our interest further because she became boring at times. And I think that the same applied to Johnny Rotten or anyone else. We never were that concerned with the group's personal behaviour or their own particular stardom. That, in a way, is probably the only dictatorship that was laid down, and it would be considered by most people as being absolutely horrendous. But let me tell you, great art, or any real idea, has never ever worried about running a few people over. You never worry about it, because the idea is more important. And if we had a good idea, and we believed in it, then it was the idea, hook and by crook, to get through. And that's what we did, and I think that's why we've been accused of being evil or Svengalis or whatever it is, manipulating, conniving. And that's absolutely true. I wouldn't deny for one minute that any things that people conjured up in the newspapers and people, you know, blown out of sometimes all proportion, there are great elements of truth in it all. Yes, we did do some very dastardly acts, but don't regret it for one minute. Otherwise, it would have been a hell of a boring job.
All work, no joy, makes Mac a dull boy.
Always wanted to challenge convention. And just as my grandmother said, when I got wicked at school, and wicked at work, and wicked with my mother, boys will be boys. To question authority and challenge conventions is what makes my life exciting. And I shall continue.
Unabated.
All work, no joy, makes Mac a dull boy. All work and no joy
makes Jack, makes Mac, and every other kind of hack a dull B-O-Y boy.
Ha 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 ha